today on Sing for Your Supper with Bob Waggoner.
You know, Bob, I love to cook, and first rule of thumb is I never bathe before I cook.
Multi-Grammy award-winning singer-songwriter Amy Grant learns how to prepare skillet-seared foie gras.
Salsa beef, have you ever seen these guys?
No.
Then Bob and his chef of the day prepare beef tenderloin over salsa beef.
I didn't know you liked it raw. I wouldn't have gone to all this trouble.
Finally, Amy is asked to sing for her supper on the stage of Nashville's historic Ryman Auditorium.
How's about cooking something up with me?
Sing for Your Supper with Bob Waggoner is made possible by... Along Argentina's Route 22, winemaking pioneers found a patch of land made for crafting Malbec wine. Route 22, for the art of film. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bob Waggoner.
Hey everyone, welcome to Sing for Your Supper. I'm Bob Waggoner. I have an amazing show today because I have singer, songwriter, recording artist extraordinaire, Amy Grant on the show with us today. I'm so excited you're here. We're gonna eat, we're gonna drink. And I brought someone special. I have Seema Prasad from Miel Restaurant here in town, who's going to pour some fun wine with the dishes that we're doing. Round of applause for Seema. We're going to get right into this. I have a foie gras dish. We're going to sear a duck liver. We've got a sweet potato here. Oil them down. Pop them in the oven at 300, 320. When it's so soft, it's like mush. That's when he's ready. We've taken him out like this. All I've done is put this in a bowl with a little salt and pepper, a little bit of butter, and a whisk. So a lot of wonderful flavor in there. We've got some candied pecans. Toss them a little bit of honey, slow and easy, in the oven. Pull them out, and all that wonderful honey flavor will coat the outside of the pecan, so they're crunchy and wonderful. Little sunflower sprout. You ever seen these guys before?
No, but if you need me to taste test any of this.
I think we do. Let's start with these guys right there. Seema, you want one?
I do.
Mmm.
They're so crunchy.
So a little sunflower sprout. We're going to use this just as a little garnish, and it's got a little bit of herbal flavor to it. Got some chopped shallots, and we have some yuzu juice. Have you ever had yuzu juice?
Japanese fruit,
sort of a lemon-lime combo, but really, really flavorful. We're not going to use a lot because it's really strong and very pungent. And then we've got some really, really strong flavorful maple syrup, some salt, some fresh ground pepper, and easy enough. Let's get going. I'm gonna get the pan pretty hot. We're gonna add a little bit of grapeseed oil. A lot of times you don't need to use for foie gras, you can just do it in a plain pan. So salt and pepper. We're gonna do both sides of these guys. So foie gras, so this is a duck liver. You like foie gras?
I do. I've never made that, actually.
Oh, good. I'm just going to get the pan almost to a smoking point, and I'm going to pour a little bit of that oil out. So there's just a tiny bit in there.
Okay.
This is very, very fatty, and the toughest thing about this recipe, it's going to smell like foie gras in here for about 6 weeks. But it's one thing that it really gets smoky, so make sure you've got every window in the house. So you open the front door, the back door, and the two side windows.
Exactly.
You'll kind of get the smoke out of the house.
That's good. You know, Bob, I love to cook, and first rule of thumb is I never bathe before I cook. Because hair, everything, your eyebrows absorb the smell of the food.
As you will today.
Oh, gosh. Where was I going? Okay, I might have to rethink the rest
Vince
of my
Vince is going to say, you smell like foie gras today, honey. What's
I don't think he's ever met foie gras before. So he is a meat and potatoes man.
You know what? This is the perfect time. Now you're going to see how to cook foie gras. You're going to be able to.
I love that.
All right, let's get that in there. I'm going to let that sear. Usually we do this on the hottest flame you could possibly get. It's gonna start getting hot there. While that's searing, I'm gonna make our little vinaigrette. So a little yuzu juice. Up.
All right.
Salt and pepper in there. You wanna get that salt in with the citrus so it dissolves rather than just sit at the bottom. I'm gonna flip that over. Up.
So where can you get foie gras like that? I mean, it doesn't come out of the bird like that.
It doesn't come out of the bird. Well, actually, it does come out of the bird like that. I think there are some specialty shops. You probably won't find it at your local supermarket because it's ridiculously expensive.
Little goes a long way.
Little goes a long way. So we're going to let him just sear like that. And just to the touch like that, he's just going to be just medium rare, almost to a medium point. Now we're going to add a tiny bit maple syrup to our vinaigrette. And then a tiny bit of grapeseed oil, just so there's a little oil in there. And then raw shallots. I like the bite of raw shallots in there, too. So we're going to start out with a small amount of sweet potatoes.
Love those.
And these guys are ready to go. I'm going to pull one off and just down through it like that. Put our foie gras on top like that. A couple of these little sprouts. It's around. couple of little pecan guys.
Perfect color combo, sweet potatoes and the sprouts.
The citrus is gonna be down the bottom, so we're gonna make sure we get a little bit of him. Then on top like that. There you go. Amy Grant's foie gras. Give it a try, give it a try. And Seema's actually got some wine that she's gonna pour. What are we gonna drink with this, Seema?
We've chosen a Moscato. This is from Southeast Australia. So a little bit unusual for Moscato, but they make a great product. It is slightly frizzante, so that's gonna have just a few bubbles. And the sweetness of the wine, it's kind of got tropical fruit flavors, pairs classically with foie gras. So always a little bit of sweetness and white wine.
Okay.
Why don't you try that?
Fantastic. Mm. I've never been so conscious of my manners in my whole life.
You can grab it with your hand if you want to.
Okay, I'm just going to try this.
Just dig into it and go for it. Is it fun?
Mm-hmm.
Do you get that yuzu juice? Can you find that real citrusy flavor and then the maple that kind of balances it out?
Yes. That's great.
There you go.
That's really good. Everybody's so curious now, right?
Give it a try with the wine.
See what you think.
Seema, did you try it with the wine yet?
I did. It is that pairing that you search for. The wine makes the food better, the food makes the wine
better.
Still
a lot of freshness. Good combo.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. We've had a little foie gras, that was fun. And now my favorite part, one of my favorite parts of the show. If I have someone in the crowd who's gonna cook with me today, let's track down Beverly Mansfield. Round of applause for Beverly. And Beverly, I know this is no surprise because you guys have been friends forever.
That's right. I've been in this seat before. Talking life while Bev's cooking.
You know what, we're gonna wash your hands real quick.
Do you ever put your potatoes just in a sink of soapy water?
Never, why would we do that?
Because they grow in dirt. I always like do a big thing of soapy water. No, I do.
Are you excited about this guy?
That's why I asked.
You've been looking at him for a while.
Me just a tiny bit.
Maybe we should put the salsify in the soapy water for a little while, and then we go in. No, are we okay?
Okay, go ahead.
You know what that is?
What?
Beef tenderloin. We actually just cut this sort of the chateaubriand, is what the French call it. Mm-hmm. If you have a whole beef tenderloin, all you're really needing to do is just trim off a little silver skin that's on here, and it's say $12 a pound when it's a whole beef tenderloin, whereas later on we're gonna cut maybe 6 or 8 slices out of that for your guests. All of a sudden those slices in a small packet or $19.95 a pound. Take a look at this. Salsify, have you ever seen these guys?
No.
Known as the oyster root, and it's just a really fun root, very rustic flavor. The French use it a lot. 11 years in Burgundy, we put it in a lot of dishes. We've got some little pearl onions that we peeled, some smoked bacon, some fresh thyme. You know how to blanch asparagus?
Well, the way I would blanch asparagus might be in a double boiler.
Oh, cool.
You know, like boil the water underneath, steam it, blanch it like that. How should I be doing it?
No, that's a great way to do it. Actually, that keeps a lot of wonderful flavor in it also. What I'll do is have a real hot pot and almost seawater, salty. That's why these guys are so green like that.
Oh.
You can do that the day before.
Okay.
So you're ready to go. I try and do things so you can just get it done easy so you can sit and drink with your girlfriend and not have to worry about it. So. A little bit of butter, we've got some beef stock, some red wine, some grapeseed oil, and salsify. It's really sticky on the inside, so we're gonna give you some of these guys. Didn't think you'd have to wear gloves today, did you? There you go. There you go, ready to go. So now what we're gonna do is peel these guys. I'm just gonna give you one to peel. We don't need that many. So just go ahead and just hold them like this. Just peel from there to there.
Okay.
We're not gonna use that much. But you wanna get all that black part off.
Seems like you should be doing this, Amy.
No. Oh, wait, actually, I'll give you something to do.
That's my sous chef.
You wanna help? Is the sous chef gonna help? Can you pick time? Just kinda go in the opposite direction of the step from the top and just go like that.
Is that good enough?
Just a little bit. Perfect, look at that. Great job, guys, round of applause. Look at that, she's doing salsify. First, I guarantee you that's the first time anyone's ever done salsify on the stage at the Ryman. That's a good thing.
Okay, I'm gonna sound like an idiot. I have always put the whole thing in.
We can do that too, but we're just gonna add it at the end, just in the sauce.
But then you're always kind of going, what's that stick between my teeth?
Well, you can put the stick in.
Sure,
you can do it in soups and things. You can put it in early and it'll help. Let's go ahead and cut that little guy off.
Nice.
Really sharp. And for me, whenever I hold a knife, I try and hold it up as far as, I like to hold, put my thumb there mm-hmm. and that finger there. Mm-hmm. And then you've just got a lot, okay. it won't slide. So sometimes when you've got a carrot, if you're way back here, I think it bounces around, you don't have as much leverage as when you're up on top like that.
All right.
You don't have to do it that way, but it's, if you're in the kitchen, that's
so
what I'm gonna have you
off.
Do. Just cut that guy off, there you go. Now we're gonna try and slice that guy. You good
what
with that?
Slices.
Do it as thin as you can. Look at that, she's doing great.
How many of these?
Just a round of applause.
Not just because of the movie, like Water for Chocolate, but I think people can feel emotion in food. And so when a dinner's really special, even though it would be easier to cater or have somebody else do it, I try to do the cooking.
Yeah.
Because I think
yes.
people...
Well, because we found that even if it's a simple meal, it means more to... take it off your own stove.
I think so too.
Now we're gonna cut these little guys in half. They're gonna probably slide around. Maybe we'll do that with a paring knife.
Sure.
Just up, just like that.
Okay.
Cut those guys in half.
All right.
Amy's got our time ready.
Did you want all of it
we'll
or do you just want
just a tiny bit more actually.
What is
more
that? Time,
that's what we all want.
Exactly.
Too bad.
Time is money.
Because we're on camera, we can't do what we would normally do while we're cooking, which is analyzing all of life, solving the problems of the world.
Is there any wine
telling
involved?
Secrets.
Yes, there's wine involved. We would also sing.
What would you be singing while you're cooking?
Give me just a little more time.
Yep.
Our love will surely grow.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah. Oh, that was perfect.
Yeah.
You had me going there. That was perfect. Grapeseed oil in this guy.
How much?
A little bit. Go ahead and I'll let you know. A little bit more, a little bit more. All right. Now let's put our salsify in there. Get them sautéing around.
What happens if you eat it raw? Does it kill you or something?
No, it's not bad. It's just give it a try. It's not great. It's crunchy. It's almost like a radish.
Is it hot?
Let's go ahead and no. Let's go ahead and get those guys in there too.
It tastes a little bit like a radish without the bite, maybe.
Can you give that guy a little toss?
Like a real toss?
If you're well, you're up. As long as you keep a little bit in, because she's hungry. Let me show you. What we're going to do, you want to get it all the way down in the end, and then you come back. Here's the mat. That's where you want to put it back, and then and then just kind of pull it back towards you. Look at that! She's tossing.
You ever done that?
Rock the boat.
You want to toss?
Rock the boat, baby.
Is it hot or no? Oh, okay. All right.
Okay.
You ready? Yes! That was perfect! It's all right. Just keep a... Yeah, there's a couple more. That's okay. Put them back in. Three-second rule.
There's that other song, tossing and turning,
Perfect. We need a little salt and pepper.
All night.
Let's go ahead and grab the salt. Okay. Sprinkle a little bit of salt in here.
Tossing and turning all night. That's an old one. That's got to be 62, tossing and turning all night.
A little bit of cracked pepper. All right, now we're going to slice, take that knife, and give it about... Yeah, perfect. Let's do... How many of those do you want? One?
Amy? She wants like five.
I'd like just one little bite of raw is what I'd like.
There you go.
She likes to eat it raw.
We can do that. Are you serious?
Yeah. Four girls in our family, when fondue first came out, my mother went and got a fondue pot and said, what's the best thing to cook? And he said, tenderloin. So I came home from school one day, and she's slicing up, cubing tenderloin, and she would like, cube six, eat one.
Perfect.
Cube
we'll
six, eat one.
Okay. You go leave it there.
I said, what are you doing? She said, it's just like butter.
If I'd have known you liked it raw, I wouldn't have gone to all this trouble to do all this stuff, but that's okay. That's perfect. We're going to put some grapeseed oil in here. And you want it hot like that, too, smoking. One thing great about this grapeseed oil is you can get it really, really hot.
So the alarms aren't going to go off in here or anything?
If we burn down the Ryman, we will have a lot of bad PR. I guarantee you that. It's not a good sign. But at least, Amy, you were here with me when it went down. So now we can...
One more
and
memory.
We know where the back door is. So that's
another
even
memory.
Better. You want to try and keep them all about the same size. And they're going to go really quick.
I'm absorbing
smell. Right, let's give them a little flip. You eat it raw, I'm not even going to ask you how you like your beef tenderloin cooked, because that makes it even easier on me. That's the cereal you're looking for. All of that flavor is going to be in the bottom of the pan now. We didn't shake it around. We didn't move it around.
And I've heard you only want to turn these one time when you're cooking them, right?
That's it. That's all we're doing. And every time you cook a meat, if he can rest a little bit and just relax, just whenever you're stirring it, have another glass of wine.
Sing another song.
That would be good, too. Let's pull these guys. For me, they're done.
I'm not very good with these songs.
Yeah, it's okay. It's good. You know what? You do it the other way. Kind of go like a...
Like that?
There you go. Give it that a shot.
Ah.
Look at that.
Maybe I could get a job in your kitchen.
Come on down. We do the watermark. We'll take you guys on and put you to work. Let's go baking in here. See all that souk is the French stay stuck to the bottom of the pan. Whenever we deglaze that, it's going to come up. I'm going to get rid of a little of that fat just because we're going to put a whole bunch of new flavorful fun fat in there. I was going to say put a little bit, but obviously you want some bacon in your sauce.
Oh, no, okay. I can take it out.
No, no, it's perfect. Are you kidding?
Why?
Are you having trouble with a lot of bacon?
No, I'm
done. Okay, let's do that, and let's get this pan going. Put a little bit of butter in here.
Okay, this reminds me when she threw that bacon in. We had a large gathering at our house, and I keep my salt in a dish, and I handed it to this young man and said, would you salt the salad? And I turned around and I said, I need salt for something. He said, oh, I put it on the salad. Ooh, with the whole dish, and then I'm trying to act like...
Salt and pepper.
That's okay.
It'll be good, it'll be good.
You know that big bowl of salad?
Oh my gosh.
It shrunk down to about that big. It was like...
Yeah, I guess it like does a thing to
it's like
it.
Like salting a slug.
Red wine,
like...
right, that little one. Nope, that guy right there. Go ahead, it's gonna splatter a little bit, so be real careful. Just pour it all in at one time. So red wine, we're deglazing the pan with the red wine.
Oh yeah.
That's gonna reduce down really quickly, and it's taking up all that wonderful flavor. We're gonna add a little bit of beef stock in there also. And now all we've done with the asparagus is just toss them a little bit of whole butter and salt and pepper. And now it's decoration time.
Here?
You're gonna impress your girlfriend and decorate that as best you can.
Okay.
We've cooked on buses with electric skillets.
Yep. Now what would be the bus meal?
Well, breakfast.
Okay.
Because we travel all night.
So you don't get to eat in restaurants?
Yeah. Mm. You just don't always want to.
So I'm gonna let you grab a little of those guys and put them on there. So salsify.
Ooh, that looks
caramelized
good.
Grilled onions.
Caramelized.
Easy enough. Can you guys do this? Is this gonna be a girls' night out dinner
or something?
Can you guys all do this? All right, looking good. Let's go ahead and grab one of those pieces of meat, whichever one you think's the prettiest one, and you want to serve your best friend.
Oh, my gosh. Of course, the biggest one.
Thank you.
Of course, the biggest one. Let's take a little bit, maybe two pats of butter out of there. And that's going to finish off the sauce. It's going to just emulsify a little bit. It's just going to get glossy and fun. So let's put half that thyme in the sauce. Right now at the last second, so it's all this wonderful bacon flavor. It's going to, all that fat is going to give the bacon fat seared off, all that flavor and herbs right at the last second. I'm going to let you spoon a little sauce over the top of that.
Oh, man.
A little bit of red wine reduction.
Wow.
No stems in there for Amy.
Sorry. This is for her.
Oh, you're going to eat
some. Enough?
That is perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, Beverly's Filet. Thanks over here. Enjoy these guys. Tima, what are we going to drink with it?
We are going to drink, classically, we have red meat. We are going to drink Cabernet Sauvignon. This is from California, and it's going to be fairly full-bodied Cabernet with a little bit of all fun stuff, a little Petit Verdot and Merlot, a little Malbec in there.
Loving that.
Yeah. Rich, but soft.
To good friends.
Yep.
Thank you so
good
much.
Good food.
Tima.
Good wine.
Great pick. Let's taste your best friend's dish and see how she did. Thumbs up to the best friend. She did a great job, ladies and gentlemen. Beverly Mansfield, best friend beef dish. And now this is my favorite time, I guarantee you. There's a whole lot of people that have been watching this show for one reason. What would that possibly be?
Sing a song?
Come on.
Sing for your supper?
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, Amy Grant.
I remember the first time I came to the Ryman Auditorium. I was in the seventh grade, and I sat in the balcony, sort of in that direction, and Dolly Parton and Porter Waggoner were here that night. And I was just sat up there in rapt attention. I had a just crazy crush on a boy in my class, and he did not notice me at the time, but I was looking down at Dolly with all of her womanliness and dreaming of what I might have someday to get his attention, which never panned out, but Anyway, it was a great memory, and who would have ever thought we'd be here on the same stage singing a song? So this is a new one. I hope you guys like it.
Sing for yourself.